and my pants had caught on fire. Both the jetpack, you know, came down right over my rear end, and the pants, the seat of the pants, had caught on fire, and that was quite memorable. So there I was up 30 feet in the air with the fire extinguisher spraying on me, and two big holes in the back of my pants. It was very humbling experience.
I start directing in, I start prepping in a week, mm-hmm. and we get about a week to prep, and then I start actually shooting and saying action, cut, things like that.
Wow.
Yeah.
And don't
so
drop
I've been standing in
like
front, yeah, I've been standing in front of the mirror at home, you know, yeah. going, action, cut!
And action!
Commander, take your hand away from that console or I'll be forced to fire.
And cut.
Yes, I started directing on our show in the second season with an episode called Sacred Ground, which had a lot for Kate Mulgrew to do. Was a real kind of an actor-driven show, a character-driven episode, really challenging episode for Kate, and we just worked really well together on that episode, and I think she was real pleased. And yeah, it's been great. You know, I had been wanting to direct for years before I got to Star Trek. I'd been observing directors on other TV shows I did. They didn't last long enough to give me the chance to direct there. But Star Trek has been around. You know, we've done the show long enough. I've been able to direct a lot of episodes.
I ask that Kes be restored to health.
Your request is inconsequential. You have what you need to save her yourself.
He was my neighbor. Our trailers were right next to each other. So for 7 years, and our doors were always open. He came into mine, I went into his. There's nothing I don't know about you, Robbie. Nothing, remember that. And nothing he doesn't know about me. Every single family problem, every time there was a sadness, every time there was a triumph, we celebrated it together. And he directed me in Sacred Ground. Instantly knew. I went right to Berman. I said, this kid is terrific. He's got it. He's going to do it, Rick, with or without you. So I'd give him a boost if I were you. And as you can see, he's having a wonderful career. So is Roxanne.
We're going to grab a single of Tim here for Commander. Line, 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 and he gets fired. You hear that, Tim?
Yeah.
It's Commander, line, 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 and then you're fired.
Commander, line, line, you're fired.
Then you're fired.
Commander, take your hand away from that console. Or I will be forced to fire.
You must not let them stop you. You must do this.
There's always something. You know, when you're directing, there's always something you don't expect. I remember one director I was observing said to me, he said, even if you don't know the answer, pretend like you do. Give him an answer, say yes or no. You can always change your mind later. But if you ever go, I don't know, he said, because there's always going to be something you don't expect. You know, they're going to come up and say, you want the purple one or the red one? And you're not going to really know. But just say, I want the red one. Later on, you can say, you know what? I changed my mind. I really like that purple one. But at least, you know, there's always decisions. There's always things coming up. And you just have to kind of, the role of the director is to focus everyone's energies and to lead them. And even if you don't know.
Doctor to Lieutenant Paris. There's someone here who'd like to say hello.
From day one, I think we all, I don't know how it happened, but we all just felt the sense of camaraderie. And I remember some of the Next Generation cast telling us, you know, you're gonna bond in a really special way. It's like the Star Trek thing. And I kind of thought, oh yeah, right, sure. But it's true. I mean, it must be something about the concept of the show. It just creates this camaraderie that we really all feel. It's been great. You know, we all get along, we have fun, we laugh. We have more fun on this set than any other set I've ever been on. We have a good time.